We've stopped playing Destiny for 1 hour to bring you Threshold. Hi, I'm Virgie. You guys have just finished your battle, and you Rasper is sort of through Davon's pockets as a woman approaches you. She's wearing studded leather armor and has a great axe on her back. She has her hair done in kind of like a tight bun. She looks at you and she says, "Well, welcome to Marinton. My name is Virgie."
It's quite a welcoming party you had for us.
Well, that is the Marinton way. I feel terrible about what happened to your friend. I don't know how you want to pay your respects for him, but when you're done, there's an inn called the Brass Lantern. I'll go ahead and make sure that you guys have food and lodging for the night.
Great. Thank you so much.
Absolutely. Just meet me there when you're done. She heads off that direction. You can see that she enters into a small inn called the Brass Lantern. It has a brass lantern hanging out front.
Okay. Well, I guess first things first, let's
bury Davon.
Davon.
Let's bury Davon.
Okay. We don't need to bury him. We barely know him. Rasper has just finished looting his body and pocketing. He's shoving the 50 gold into his pockets.
Okay.
I put his journal away and I pick him up. I wrap him in. I use the cover on the wagon, and I pull it off and wrap him up in it.
Great. As you uncover the wagon, you see that there's a big block of marble about the size of this table, so maybe like 6 feet by 4 feet, and then maybe 4 or 5 feet deep, like tall, I guess, because it's on its side. You see that, and Clarion, you see that there's a symbol kind of carved in the front.
Of the wagon, or the...
Of the top of the marble, yeah.
The marble.
And you can, if you want to flip that around for our... great, just kind of carved as kind of a symbol on the top of it. Pretty small, but you see it.
There's something on the marble...
You think maybe it's like a mason's mark or something.
What does it look like, Clarion?
I'm more concerned with wrapping him up. I don't know if one of you wants to get on there and inspect it closer.
I'll jump onto the cart and look at it.
Great. What are your plans with
Damon? I just want to pick him up, and I don't know where to go. Could I ask a local person?
Yeah, you're looking for like a graveyard or something.
Yeah, I would.
Yeah, you see, there's a like a little town commoner nearby, and she's kind of watching from afar, and she says, "If you're looking for a place to bury him, there's a small graveyard, just a few blocks from here."
I start carrying him that way.
Great. Rasper begrudgingly takes his shoulders, as Clarion grabs his legs.
Okay.
Let's do this.
I'm going to, am I strong enough to move the cart by myself?
No.
Are we strong enough to move the carts by ourselves?
You could move it some way, yeah, like, certainly if the four of you all took part of it, you could move it, but it would be slow going and probably pretty tiresome.
Okay. Is everyone okay with doing that? We wait till they get back from burying him, and then we'll move it to the side of a building.
Oh, to the side of the street, like,
well, like
down the road.
Well, I was thinking maybe disguise it as a hay bale, so people don't take the stone. We still have to get it down south. We have a job to do.
It's true, we do. You're absolutely correct. I was proposing that perhaps we talk to our new friend Virgie. Perhaps she will have a horse or something that we could procure instead.
And just leave it in the middle of the street?
Well, no, I would go talk to Virgie, or you would go talk to Virgie, and then they would return with the horse, and then we could go and move the thing.
All right, well, we can't do anything until the other two get back, so.
This is true.
You guys come back after burying Devon. Rasper uses his shovel to make pretty quick work of making a small grave. I don't know if there were any words you wanted to say or anything like that.
No words. We knew him barely. Good man. Kunk, kunk. As he pats down the pile of dirt with the top of his shovel
the
and walks around and walks away.
Hopefully I will immortalize you in song one day, Devon.
Great. You head back. You arrive back at the cart.
Great. So we can do two things. We can either go to the inn and talk to the woman that talked to us, or move the cart somewhere and then go talk to her. What do you guys want to do?
If one of us wants to talk to her and procure a horse and move it to a safe location, that I think would be the better of the two options.
Okay.
I agree with that.
You're paying me to do whatever you please.
That is true. I am, aren't I? Why don't you stay with the cart, because you can deter anyone from stealing a big giant block of stone. As I say these words, I realize that it's kind of odd that people would try to steal a large stone.
It is marble. It is a very valuable stone.
It is also heavy.
This is very heavy, yes.
So, I guess, since no one would steal it, let's go to the inn.
At these words, I start heading down the road towards the inn, and kind of at a fast pace.
Great. You all head to the inn. You arrive at the Brass Lantern. It's a pretty run-down inn, as a lot of the town is. It looks pretty sparsely populated, and maybe it was a nice inn at one point, but a lot of the stuff has started to fall apart. It's pretty darn disheveled. You can see that Virgie has some meals laid out on the table for you, and she motions you over.
Okay, I fall and I sit down at the table.
Yes, we all do.
As you sit down, she says, "I'm really sorry that this had to happen, but it's unfortunately pretty common here in Marinton. The sons of the shipwreck are." Plaguing the entire place. Where were you headed?
Well, we were headed down south to Daramil.
Oh, okay. And is that shipment, that's its final destination?
Correct.
Yes.
Okay. Well, it's going to be pretty tough to move now without a horse, unless you want to carry it all that way. So
no.
There's no way that we could physically possibly do that.
How about I make you a deal?
Ooh, I do enjoy a good deal.
The sons of the shipwreck have been a huge problem for our town, and I've been working pretty hard to get the community to be a better place. If you would go to their hideout, which is down at the coast, you go down the cliff, down the stairs, in the shipwreck bay. If you go into their hideout and you can clear it out, then I will provide you with a horse and enough rations to get all the way down to Daramil. Or, if you'd like, I will take the shipment myself.
Wow. I think that's good.
Yes, I believe that is a good deal as well. Are there any stipulations to this clearing out?
No. I would say if you can kill their leader, then that would be the best, because otherwise it's only a matter of time. You see, the town is never going to recover if the bandits continue to just bandit everything. It's a temporary solution. The town needs to suffer a little bit, but to make it through the hard times so that it can get its economy back.
Gotcha.
And as long as the sons of the shipwreck are there to take the lost and the disenfranchised into their ranks, they're going to just continue to crop back up.
Hmm. Do you know who the leader is?
He's a man by the name of Bacon. So if you can kill this bacon, I would be very indebted.
Okay.
Oh, sounds easy enough.
Yes, I imagine this is right down your alley, Rasper. We of course accept your terms, and we will do this deed.
Great. I can help you move the cart around back, and we could maybe find some way to hide it.
Great.
Pretty
wonderful.
Easily.
Wonderful. Let's do that.
Great.
We go and do that.
Great. As you're doing that, she says, I don't know why they would have stopped this shipment. They probably thought it was something significantly more valuable than this marble.
Do you know what this symbol means?
No, I've never seen it. Maybe it's a crafter's mark or something. Something to identify the marble somehow.
Do you have a craftsman amongst the town?
Not here in town, no. We used to. Maybe 20 years ago when I was a little girl, but pretty much anyone who's worth anything has exited the town. Thus our shipwrecked friends.
Why are you here, Virgie? Why haven't you left town? You seem like good folk.
Well, I was born here, and I would really like to see this community thrive.
As would I.
Well, then we will do our best to dispatch those shipwreck folk in a hasty manner.
Excellent. Thank you. You guys cover up, you use Christine's idea to throw some hay on the top, and it looks just like a hay cart, an immensely heavy hay cart. And you see a guy in a white robe and a hood on the roof of the building, like eyeing it. Like he's gonna jump down and kill himself.
Don't do it!
As we complete that, then we bid our adieu to Virgie and start heading towards the shipwreck bay.
Great. You follow her directions. There's some winding stairs that go down the face of the cliffside. They weave back and forth. You can clearly see where the base must be. The bay has been filled amongst the coral reefs and the rocks that the area is known for. You want to move that map into the middle section? It'll kind of give us a pretty good idea. You can see Marinton and the famed coast, which is known for its sharp rocks. You can see amongst all of the rocks and stuff sticking out from the side, just lots of ships that are wrecked, including the big wreck of the big military ship that that brought the whole tower down 20 years ago. But some of the ships have lights inside of them. You can see some floating further off, and then another one up close that has a light hanging out in front of it, but you can't see any light that's coming from the outside of that one. And maybe a small ferry you can see kind of moving between the two of them. You make it all the way down, and you're about how many feet do you want to stop, or do you want to, before you get to like what looks like the entrance, that ship with the lantern hanging out in front of it, are you going to go right up to the door? I just want to make sure you guys have enough time to prepare whatever you are, whatever your plan of attack is. Here's a better way to do it. What's your plan of attack?
Walk right in.
No, wait!
Jasper has a job to do, and he knows he's...
You're gonna Leroy Jenkins us?
Do I see anybody guarding out front? Mm-mm. Then that's settled.
Is the porthole, like, open? Like, is it...
No, it's closed.
Okay.
The door, it's like a crude door has been fashioned into the front of this ship, essentially. Like, it's a hollowed out, broken part of a ship with a simple fashioned door.
Okay, so Rasper, well, we've got a job to do. He pulls out his shovel, he walks right up to the door, and he listens through the wood. Can he hear anything?
He can hear some whistling and some muttering amongst people kind of talking pretty quietly, but it sounds like they're joking.
So he looks back to his companions.
Maybe we should ask for bacon. I mean, not the food, but like the guy. Sorry, this place makes me nervous for some reason.
All right, boss. He stands back, yanks open the door, and walks on in.
The first thing that you notice is that the room is completely black.
Like the walls are black, or like it's
pitch
all
pitch black.
Pitch black
in the dark. Jamie, you can kind of see through the darkness with your dark vision,
right?
And you can see that there are some barrels and some stacks that look like maybe pallets of stacked metal, a silvery metal, but it's not silver. It's kind of like a more subdued, maybe a little bit of a bluish metal. But other than that, you don't see or hear anything.
Okay, I'm gonna pull out a torch and light it.
Okay.
To be able to see.
Great. The torch lights up the room.
Great. Is it just? Is there a door leading out of this room?
Yes, you can see on the far side.
Okay. I'm actually gonna go to the metal. And.
You guys are entering.
Mm-hmm. Yes, we are entering.
Once you're all inside the room, the door slams behind you, and you hear a click, and your torch is immediately snuffed out. Everyone roll initiative.
Yay.
19. Give me some numbers.
19.
Okay.
21.
I love it.
Yes.
19.
20.
20. I love how much time this saves. Yeah. Like, it is a little hokey.
Yeah.
But I love it. All right. So we're at the top of the order. Rasper. You guys are all effectively blinded, except for Jamie.
Slightly
you
less
see.
Blinded.
Rasper, he's a little taken aback by the darkness, and he screams into the darkness, "Show yourselves!"
There's no reaction, but you can hear, no one shows himself, of course, but you can hear someone barking saying, "Oh, looks like you're having a little bit of trouble down there."
Okay, who's next?
Allow me to illuminate the situation. And you just feel a sword against the side of you, or, well, we'll see if one's coming. So I get advantage, because you are blinded. Oh, very interesting. 7.
No.
All right, describe my miss.
Rasper...
So it's going to come at you through the darkness.
The whoosh of a sword comes at Rasper, and he instinctively dodges it. Just before he swipes his shovel towards the sword's direction.
Okay. Go ahead. You were, I'm assuming, taking a readied action.
Yes.
So go ahead and give me a disadvantaged attack roll.
Okay.
That's 2d20.
So yeah, you roll 2 and take the lower.
Right. Okay. 18.
Yep, that's gonna do it.
Alrighty.
So give me some damage.
Or describe the...
Oh, yeah, describe it.
I guess there's not much to describe, as Rasper can't see anything, but the shovel comes down and hits something with a crunch.
And you want to deal some damage?
Yes.
Ooh,
14.
Woo! Great. You hear... I'm going to describe this. You hear a... You don't hear a crunch, you actually hear a and then a thump. what Jamie can see as a decapitated head, as Rasmus just instinctively just goes clean through the guy. So next is Glareon.
Can anyone see in this darkness?
I can slightly see.
What just happened? Did I get him?
You just brained a guy. His head's at my feet now. Good shot.
Well, what does he look like?
All right, Clarion, take your turn. Too much team talk during this initiative order.
Sorry.
Perfect.
No problem.
Well, then, hopefully, the words of Damaren's Folly will inspire you to take down our enemies. Between his wobbling knees and beard full of fleas, he barely could climb up the stairs.
And who is that?
I am inspiring Jamie. Bardic inspiration.
Great. Jamie's inspired. That's your turn?
Yep.
Great. Jamie, what's your passive perception?
My passive perception is 9.
You notice on either side of the room, because you can see in the darkness, you can see that there are actually big sheets of like thick canvas taped on, not taped, but nailed to either side of some windows that's blocking the light from coming in.
I can see that?
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to take my an action. I'm going to cast Phantasmal Force.
Okay.
I'm going to create, that means I can make an image that is in a 10-foot cube, obviously.
Okay.
And I'm going to do it so that it appears there's a wall around my party members.
Okay. Great. Do I get like a will saving throw against that?
It's an int check versus my spell save. If you inspect it. If you take an action to inspect it.
Oh, if I take an action.
Yeah. Well, you have to like inspect it to make
perfect. Sure. Okay. So to these guys, a wall appears.
Wait, that's actually only the one guy.
Okay. So you can see that three other guys have come up from behind the barrels and stuff. They were hiding, but you can see them through the darkness.
Yes, and I cast one on that guy.
On one of the guys.
Yeah.
Great. He looks at it and he says, "Ah, there's some wizardry here. There's a wall. He's warping the ship." Christine.
Okay. I'm going to take. I'm going to relight the torch.
Okay, you can't. The sparks.
I can't at all.
The sparks seem to not catch. The torch isn't catching.
Okay.
Perhaps some magic.
Okay, then I'm going to find a like a corner, like a wall.
Okay.
And like put my back against it so that nothing can come from behind me.
Great. You feel your way backwards as you try to light the torch. You hear someone say, "Looks like you can't light your torch." what was that voice? It's happening. Fuck you, Thurman. Looks like you can't light your torch. And the guy who was who thinks that there's a wall, he starts kind of coming at Christine, who's back in the corner. And he says, "I bet you wish you could see right about now." And he is going to attack you with his sword. 20.
Hit.
It's a natural 20.
Ooh.
Ooh.
Okay. So I roll twice.
Yeah.
We got this note last time.
Yeah.
11.
Damage?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's a really good sword blow. He comes at you just swinging, and since you can't really see in the darkness... he gets a pretty good cut across your face, but not enough to bring you down.
Okay.
Then the guy who just laughed at you, he looks at Jamie and he says, "What are you talking about? There's no wall!" And he's gonna leap down from an upper level from the stack of barrels, and he's gonna come down hard with the sword on Jamie. 20.
That's a big old hit. Yep.
2 damage. He barely misses any vital organs. You maybe get a torn sleeve. He takes one of the sleeves off of your shirt as it comes down, but it doesn't deal you any mortal damage.
Oh yeah. Okay.
Finally, this last guy, he pulls out a rapier and he says, "So, you think you can kill my friend?" And he comes at Rasper with a rapier, and he's going to just try to drive it into his stomach. I have advantage. 10, does that miss?
It misses.
Great, describe my miss.
He comes at Rasper and trips, like, he hobbles across the deck, catches something just enough to... miss.
Great. He just like barely puts it through the side, but you do feel someone close by you. You feel him kind of hit you with his hand as he misses.
And
so you're going to know where he is, because we're back at the top, and it's your turn.
And in turn, the shovel, he whips around like the stock of a gun, and,
uh-huh.
and right about at the height of someone's face.
Great. Give me another roll at disadvantage.
Yes. Is that a 17? So 18.
Yep, that's yeah. enough.
All right. Some damage. And a 10.
Great. He's going to go down.
All right. Rasper puts a little too much muscle into this butt blow and just gores this guy right in the... He can feel it hit and then mush a little further.
Oh! his face just goes in. Jamie, you can see like his face kind of caved in. Rasper butts him with the gun. We're on to Clarion.
I back up to a wall and unsheath my dagger. I can't fight any of them, and I'm all out of inspiration. Hopefully I can help.
Jamie something.
Alright, I'm still in battle. I'm still engaged with this guy.
Uh-huh.
Okay, I'm going to, remove myself.
Great.
I can use my move action mm-hmm. to remove myself from combat.
Yes.
And I'm going to run to one of those sheets.
Uh-huh.
And then attempt to grab it and then pull it.
Great. Give me a strength check.
Strength check. Yippee skidoo. Strength check. Go. 15.
Great. You tear it down as moonlight pours in, illuminating the whole room. You can see the guys, they go, ah! And they cover their eyes a little bit. They wince at the light that's now coming in the room. You see their pupils are like really dilated. Christine.
Great. Can I have advantage against the guy that's right in front of me?
Yeah.
Great.
You sure do.
So I'm going to drop the unlit torch and just pull out my great axe, swing it at him. 24. My bad.
Still.
8 damage.
Okay, it's not gonna bring him down, but it's gonna do a whole heck of a lot.
Great, I'm gonna bring it down on his shoulder, right where his, arm meets his shoulder, and just slice
Great.
Right into it,
you,
either dislocating or cutting it off.
You dislocate his arm.
Great.
You dislocate his arm, and it's, he cries out in pain, you... Big bitch! your torch clatters to the ground as you drop it. It's this guy's turn to kind of retort now. He kind of bends down, careful not to provoke a swing, to pick up his sword with his offhand, and he's gonna massively disadvantaged try to swing at you offhanded that he can barely see. 14?
Nope.
Great. Tell me my miss.
Okay. He swings wildly and just totally overshoots me.
Great. Next is the guy who is engaged with Jamie, who was engaged with Jamie now, is going to kind of shield his face away from the moonlight that's pouring in. He's going to back himself away towards a wall, and he's going to kind of cower in the corner, but he's going to hold his sword out in an attempt to attack anyone who's coming at him. This guy's so dead. We're back up at the top with Rasper.
Rasper now can see that he has thrust the back end of his shovel into one of these things' skulls. And can you describe what they look like now?
They're people. They're they are sons of the shipwreck. They have their... you know, their blue bandanas up on their face, or this guy did. The bandana and his crushed-in face is kind of like still having his limp body hang against your shovel. the big guy who is apparently just dislocated his arm, he had like a big beard, and he's kind of a bigger guy. The guy that is cowering in the corner is kind of a shrewy, mousy face with like a big overbite. And the guy who you just killed has like dark hair and a mustache, who looked maybe more like a fencer type, but he's totally gone. The headless guy doesn't have a head, so his face, he doesn't have a face.
All right, Rasper, as he's pushing the body off, you know, getting it off of his shovel, he's saying, "You guys die too easy. We won't have anyone to question if this goes on long." And he kind of throws the guy to the dead one to the ground and turns up. And how close is the big guy compared to the guy in the corner?
Which one's closer? Probably the big guy.
Okay.
Big guy fighting Christine.
He stops over to the big guy and goes for just a whack at the back of his neck. Bat hair is back. And we are no longer at disadvantage now?
Yes.
Okay. Nat 20.
Woo! So you roll twice. So here's another D10. So roll both of those. Gotcha. Bring the pain.
19.
19. Plus your strength.
Plus 23.
you're gonna pulp him. tell me how you swing, and I'll describe how he dies.
I swing right at like midsection spine.
Okay.
With the flat edge of the blade.
Great. Your blade goes right between two of his vertebrae, and additionally just like carves out a good section of his internal organs as you split him totally in two. He grabs at his stomach as he collapses onto the ground, disoriented, bleeding out, pretty much instantly dead. But he doesn't feel any pain from the feet down, so that's a plus.
Rasper quickly makes do with this guy.
A good portion of blood and fecal matter from his lower intestine gets onto Christine's lower half.
Why would you do that?
Without skipping a beat, Rasper stomps over to the guy in the corner and grabs him by the shirt and picks him up toward him. And we're looking for a man by the name of Bacon.
Clarion, it's your turn.
Rasper, I think this man's gotten the point, and I think he won't. Now, sir, you're not gonna be. I'm all exposition. You're not gonna be winning this fight now, so I think you best leave, and we won't kill you like the rest of your friends.
Okay.
And never come back.
I'll get out of here. Just let me go.
Oh good, he survived. I'm so glad.
Good old Thurman. He starts to wiggle out. Do you let him go?
I look toward Christine, my employer.
She looks like
I look to the other two.
I think he's gotten the point, and I don't think he's going to be doing his...
Rasper kind of chucks him to the floor.
Great. You see him go out the back door, and he drops a little rod on his way out, and you can see a button on the top go click up. The torch springs back to life, which is now...
On the ground.
Burning. And the floor... maybe a little too quickly catches fire. He heads out. You see him head out the back door as it explodes as he runs, and you can see him get on the ferry and start paddling it away from shore.
I'm gonna snap myself out of my mini panic attack, grab the rod and like jam, like press the button.
It looks maybe broken.
Okay.
The room is now pretty much totally in flames.
Anyone with magic want to help here? Because I can't really do anything.
I say we get out of here as quick as possible. Yes. That's about magical.
I could make the fire look like a different kind of fire.
Unfortunately, you guys noticed that the only exit would be through the Shark Fang coast out to the other ship. Because it's only the back entrance, because the torch is by the front entrance. But as you guys are kind of realizing that you're either going to have to swim or put out the fire. Brian, your raven pendant starts to glow, and the salt ocean water starts to sort of freeze in a direction towards the ship as a ice bridge starts to form all the way out to the other side.
I kind of like look down. I go, of course, right now.
Thanks,
you,
Jamie.
Thank you. Yes, it's me. I'm doing all this. Let's go.
I'm going to, as I run out of the corner, I'm going to grab one of the bars that I see.
Great. Yeah, one of the bars of metal.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome.
And run out onto the bridge following it.
Great. As you guys are running across the bridge, it freezes the ferry and even beyond all the way out to where you need to go. And you can see that Thurman, now that he can no longer steer the thing, he goes, and he starts to try to slip and crawl his way further out, but he falls off and falls into the water and pulls himself back up. And as you're crossing the bridge, he makes it to the other side. Additionally, Brian, as you're walking, you kind of see your raven kind of turn towards you and says, oh, now child, let mother take care of this one.
Do we hear this?
No. You guys don't even see the raven move.
All right.
And you can make it to the other side.
Great.
I say to the pendant, it's like, this doesn't mean anything. You don't get any more from this.
The raven returns to normal as if it had never moved.
I turn back to my friends, kind of back in the real world, and go, let's keep going. It's not going to last long. Let's go.
Okay. We run all the way across.
Great. You make it to the other side. This one looks like maybe a fancier ship.
Can I punch Thurman as we're
running? Yeah. Great. Roll.
Oh, I don't want to tell you the number I rolled.
What'd you roll?
It might be a natural one. this is why I don't do fun things.
Great, tell me what happens.
Oh, crap. I go, he's still kind of climbing
uh-huh.
up. I'm running, and as we're running, I see him trying to climb up. I attempt to punt him in the head
uh-huh.
with the kick, fall on my back, and then fall into the ocean.
Great, you fall into the cold ocean. But it actually, for you, feels kind of refreshing.
Yeah.
And you're quickly able to climb out.
And then continue running.
Yeah. So you guys make it across. This ship looks to be a little bit nicer than most of the other ships. It clearly was chosen because it was at one point a lavish royal navy ship, or maybe some kind of merchant lord. But it looks very nice. You can see that, again, a crude door has been carved in the front of it.
Great. Taking caution to the wind this time... I am going to hold Rasper back and peek around the corner.
Rasper, for the record, if we didn't let him live, we would have been fine.
I couldn't deal with it. I couldn't deal with that at the moment. You kind of made a mess of things.
Mm-hmm. Well, things get messy when you're killing people.
I'll take the bet on that one, guys. I said let him go. Sorry.
You have this conversation in front of the closed door. You can hear, this is the ship that had the lights on the inside. You can hear the lights on the inside and a couple people maybe having a conference.
I put my ear to the door while they bicker.
Great. Give me a perception check.
Five.
You, other than that there's voices, you can't really make much more out.
Stinger shout.
Do you hear anything?
I can't hear anything on the other side.
Hmm.
Well.
Other than the voices.
But not what they're saying.
Can't distinguish anything.
Is it just, the ice path leads up straight to the door and doesn't have a dock or like a...
Yeah, it has a small landing area where the ferry would land.
There are no windows or anything on that landing area? No.
Well, we only have one direction to go. I'm gonna open up the door.
Yeah. Rasper, at your leisure, sir.
Great. You can see that there are four, they look to be more like standard sons of the shipwreck, kind of having a conference with a small map of the city on a table, but also seated with them, a guy who is pretty much clearly their captain. He looks like a older, maybe in his 50s, human. He has a big beard and horns on his helmet, and you can see that he has a couple of a hand axe and a throwing axe, a battle axe and a hand axe in front of him at the table, kind of seated, and it looks like you have disturbed him from something pensive, and he looks up and he rises from his chair, pushing it back, and he grabs his axe and he says, "What is the meaning of this?"
Okay.
We come for bacon.
I'm bacon.
Well, we're here to kill you. Nothing personal.
Well, kill or ask you kindly to leave, Marinton. It's your choice.
Leave? Why would I leave?
Because we'll kill you if you don't.
Yeah. I'm going to pull out my great axe and, for those of you watching at home, it is shaped like a manta ray. Yes. If that means anything to him, now would be the time.
he looks at it and he says, "So, you think you're some Demarin here to claim your birthright or some shit? Well, listen here. Your father was sworn to protect this area, this town, and he failed. So now it leads to me, and I'm doing it the best way that I know how." And you hear a voice from behind you guys say, "There's a better way." It's Virgie.
Hey.
And she says, "For long enough, Dad, you have tried and you have failed to do anything with this town. This violence and this banditry is absolutely not the answer." And he says, "This is just like you, undermining me at every turn." He says, "So if this is your newest scheme, have at it. Kill them all."
Rasper, don't kill Bacon, just maim him.
Everyone roll initiative. I love that we still roll the die. Like,
I think I got the same.
19.
Great.
Okay. I got this number.
Oh, beautiful. I'm going to draw this room real fast.
Perfect.
Why does it have to be her dad?
Virgie Bacon.
Virgie Bacon.
Virgie?
Was Bacon the first name or is Bacon the last name?
Bacon is the last name.
Ah, okay. So he's like Tom Bacon?
His name is Virgil Bacon.
Virgil Bacon?
Okay, that makes sense.
So it's a family name.
He named her. That's weird.
Oh, it's not that weird.
Is Virgil a, what's Virgie's, like, given name?
Virginia?
Is it Virginia?
Mm-hmm.
It could be Virginia.
I don't know her.
It's Virgie.
It's Virgie?
Oh.
Yeah.
I don't know if Virgie was short for something or not.
That was my guess is that it was Virginia.
Virginia's a good...
Virgie, yeah. Virginia.
Yeah, that would have been smart.
Nah, let's name it Virgie.
Kind of tight quarters here.
Oh, yeah.
Ooh. Okay, is that the door that we came in?
Yes, that's the door that you came in.
Put me in the front.
Mm.
It might be dangerous.
Next to Christine.
Hopefully the bridge...
What is that what? A hole? Is that a hole in the ship?
I think that's the table they're talking around.
Yeah, yes, that is the table. Here, there's Virgie.
Virgie.
Bullywog is a stand-in for a regular guy. This is Virgil. And a couple more.
Oh, man. What is the rest of the ship? Is it just a wall?
Yeah, what's all this?
That is assumedly back rooms. There's probably a door behind him. I should have drawn it. Behind Virgil. No, there's a ladder up here that leads to a second level that maybe explores more of the ship.
Okay. Great.
Can you describe this table? Is it like a big table? Small
yeah,
table?
It's a big round table. It looks like maybe it looks heavily water damaged, but it was maybe a war room table at one point. and it has some mana ray carvings, so it was probably taken from the castle at a certain point, but it's been clearly like water damaged and was obviously pulled out of the sea from when the tower fell.
Gotcha. Are there planks running across, anything like that? Or?
Yes, there are lots of planks running across the whole ship, and they look pretty
good enough for me. Initiative, I guess.
Yeah, Christine is actually first on this one.
Oh, great. I'm going to take, I guess, wherever I'm placed, a 5-foot step so that I'm near both of those guys. Yeah, that works. I'm going to get this the bullywog stand in.
Great. This is actually, it looks like a maybe female. she's a half bullywog, and half human, half bullywog.
What human would have sex with a bullywog?
An unwilling one.
Oh.
She has a really big smile, and her hair is in two pigtails. She growls at you as you approach her.
10.
10 is going to be a miss.
Yeah.
Tell me how you miss.
Do I miss by a lot?
No.
Okay. I swing, bringing my axe down. I miss her, but I cut off one of her pigtails.
Great. You can see that this pretty well enrages her. Ah! And she grits her teeth at you, and she's actually going to come at you. She has a club that she wields with two hands, and she's going to attack you with it. 19?
Yes.
Great. 5.
I don't Boom. Look good.
I'll describe how she hits you. She takes her club, and she glares at you after you cut off her pigtail, and she, enraged, swings the club, and she connects with your face.
Okay.
It's going to leave a nice bruise and probably a black eye. But we're moving on to Jamie.
All right. At this side of her getting hit in the face of the club, I have a question for you.
Yes.
Is there any sort of like railing or anything around the top level, or is it just...
There's a small railing up at the top level.
Cool.
And you can see that there's maybe some supplies in the back.
All right. I've seen this. I take a sidestep. And then I go like this. And course through chains, Eldritch Blast.
Your pendant glows as a bolt of ice is hurled. Who are you firing it at?
The same one that punched Christine. What's my 13 spell?
Yes.
Attack. Cool. I do a d10. 5 damage to that guy. And,
great.
And because of my repelling blast, I can push him 10 feet. I'm going to do that to fling her off the. Off the landing.
The landing's up. It goes up. You're at the lower level. But you fling her up to the second level. She goes 10 feet vertical.
Then I have to describe this a little differently then. I slide to like a knee kind of thing. And then in a rising motion, I go like this. And the blast kind of
Great.
Ups. And
you shoot an eldritch blast up her skirt. And she goes up to the second level. Oh, where she lands with a thud. Let's do this. Virgie's gonna leap over the table, and she's just gonna come at her father, with an attack, for only 12, which is actually enough.
Ooh.
And she's gonna hit him for only 3 damage as she barely connects with her axe, and she says, "Fuck you!" and cuts him across his studded leather armor. And he says, "I thought I raised you to be better." next, one of the guys, that guy right there who's next to Christine, after seeing Kathy go flying,
Kathy.
That one's Kathy. This one's name is Morris. Morris is had a couple of brass knuckles, and she's gonna just try to punch Christine in the face.
My poor face.
I know.
What is it with you and my face tonight? I get slashed. I get clubbed.
Well, you're wearing a lot of armor, so for people without swords and stuff, like, it's like, where are you unarmored? Where could they actually do damage? Your face.
Yeah.
17?
Hit.
Great. 2.
Okay.
And now it's Clarion.
Well, Bacon, did you know Davon?
I sure as hell didn't. As he and his daughter are locked in an axe battle, a great axe versus two other axes.
Well, your failures cost him his life. And I cast Dissonant Whispers as a second level spell against him. So one summer's eve, if you come to believe, he neglected to take a trip. And the ray on his shield, finally would he yield, and a galley come off the cliff. And so I cast Dissonant Whispers.
Great, what's the save?
Wisdom saving throw.
16.
That is successful. So you don't run away in fear. I think he took half damage.
As he clutches his ears, he says, "Don't compare me to that old fool!"
4 would be half of my total.
Great. You see that his eyes are significantly more bloodshot, even though he's able to cast your voices out with his sheer rage at the Damron family. Rasper,
the battle is started around him. People are fighting. He turns to the two men closest to him next to the table, and he says, "Let's make things even." And he puts his shovel away and brings out two fists.
Shing, shing. All right.
Does Rasper have names for his fists?
Not yet.
Maybe he's about to. Great. The fists come on out. let's see it. Roll two attacks.
Two attacks.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Let's see, 20 and 15? No, or yeah, 17, sorry.
Yeah, they're both gonna hit. so roll damage on both of them, but only add your strength bonus to your first one.
Okay, got it. So here's the two, I'll say 10 to one, and this guy, 2 to the other.
10 and 2.
Actually, let's even it out. Let's say just 6 and 6. That'll be better.
Okay, they're actually both gonna go down.
Okay.
Can you do that thing where you grab both their heads and like hit them together?
Yes! Yes, in fact. Rasper takes one good lunge and the two men kind of hesitate at his ferocity as he grabs their heads and shoves them together and let's go.
They're both knocked unconscious and they fall on down to the ground. Kathy's unconscious. Let's get real here.
Rasper's last words are, "Next time I guess I'll use one hand."
let's see. Down, 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 which means it's actually Virgil's turn. And he is going to swing his axe and try to cut down his daughter. He gets two attacks, one with his battle axe and one with his hand axe. And just to clarify, you were rolling d10s. I know it's supposed to be just one damage for an armed strike, but I'm letting it happen because I don't think that you should be penalized for doing awesome things. On the list of not awesome things, dropping dice off the table. Great. 10, and one of them is actually going to hit. His hand axe is going to hit.
Virgie as she dodges his first blow as comes across with the hand axe, but then with his primary hand, he's able to get a hit in for a total of 4 damage. So she looks pretty hurt as she has a good gash across her shoulders. Wonderful. Then Virgil is going to look down the line at Clarion. His eyes, after he's hit his daughter, they kind of whip, and he's going to boom, pound his foot down on a floorboard that is going to go, and it's going to try to knock you over. So make a dexterity saving throw.
Can I use acrobatics on that?
No, it's a saving throw.
Okay.
Oh, but you should be proficient in those.
22.
Great, that's way more than enough.
So I catch his intentions in his eyes, and I...
Was it?
Step backwards around the floorboard.
Kicks up, and it maybe would have knocked you over, but it didn't because you were too quick. So, Christine.
Great. Does Virgil look like she needs help?
That blow looked like it hurt her pretty good. She could only probably take a couple more of those.
Okay. I'm going to use Second Wind. So it's a 1d10 plus my fighter level. So 13 extra hit points to me.
Weep, 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 weep. You regain your resolve.
Okay. And then I'm going to... can I grab the guy's head from behind and push him back behind me?
Yeah, I don't see why.
Great, I'm going to do that. natural 20.
Great. You knock him prone.
Okay. Great, I knock him prone, and I...
he slides across the floor, getting some splinters in his face.
Perfect. And then I'm going to step next to Virgie.
Great.
I'm here to help.
Jamie.
All right, I have this guy who just slid on his face to my feet now. I'm going to do the most, obvious thing. I'm going to use my Pact of the Blade, and I'm going to take an action to summon my
long sword. Great, describe what that looks like.
So, it's basically, I go like this, and out of my raven pendant comes a white beam of light that stops around, 4 feet in front of me, and the light turns into this ice sword.
Great.
And then I grab it from in front of me.
Okay, and?
That's it. It takes an action to do
that. Okay. Great, so you have an ice sword. You have a second action. It should be a move, but I'm going to let you just take an attack action.
All right, and then I'm going to stab him. I'm going to thrust it down and try and stab him in the head.
Great.
You know how you said that was the most... Go ahead and roll. That was the most logical action. I was like, curb stomp.
Yeah. No,
go right ahead. This is way cooler.
can I get advantage?
Yeah, he's prone, actually. You do get advantage.
That's a natural 20 on that one.
Good use of advantage.
Can I get another D8, please?
Right here,
thank you.
Yeah, way cooler.
15.
Lovely. You're gonna murder him.
okay, so he slides to my feet, I go whoosh, and then in one motion I grab and then just kind of do like a very, kind of a fancy kind of maneuver and just go like this sideways. And his head just whack, just comes straight off and then kind of just rolls and goes underneath the table.
Christine would be happy to know that there's no blood that comes out of this one because the ice sword freezes the wound and the blood freezes in place. Wonderful. We are at Virgie's turn. Pamela, you just said that you're here to help. Meanwhile, in this conflict now between the three of you, Virgil says, "Help! Where were you to help 15 years ago?"
"I don't know, I was 5!
Virgie's gonna attack her father again. She's gonna hit again, and her great axe is gonna come down for a lot. for 14 damage, as it's a... awesome blow to her father's shoulder, which goes a significant portion down his chest, but it's not enough to bring him down. He still clings to life. Clarion.
Have I witnessed Virgie taking any damage? She got hit.
Yes.
Pretty well.
Yeah.
I'm here to help as well, and hopefully the words of Damaren's folly will heal you. it crashed on the side, and Damaren died as the cliff came tumbling down. And I hearing words. And that's why I roll a 1 to heal her, giving her 4 whole hit points.
The song's not helping, Clarion!
It actually does, for 4, it actually does a good deal, and she, the wound on her chest heals itself back up and leaves maybe a faint scar. She says, thanks, I guess.
I guess I do.
Rasper.
Rasper. Killing machine.
Rasper, no! I did tell you to maim, but not kill.
That's true, she did.
Right, so Rasper walks over to Bacon, whips out his shovel, and sweeps his legs.
Great. Roll it for me.
Gotta sweep the legs.
21.
Great, you knock him prone.
So he knocks down, and Rasper steps on his chest and takes a second action to attempt to restrain him.
Okay. So give
That's
me...
That's my action surge.
Yeah.
Great. So yeah, give me a strength check.
Okay. Ooh, 9.
It's opposed. 13. So you fail to restrain him, and he's actually going to, with his hand axe, he has disadvantage on this blow, but he's going to try to get you with his battle axe as you're kind of trying to get on top of him. He says, go ahead and sing those songs of Damaren. See if I care. Disadvantage, so he's going to miss by a lot.
he's injured. He clumsily goes for a swing, but clearly, does he have enough strength to even lift his heavy blade at this point?
Hardly.
So I kick the blade aside.
The hand axe the battle axe clamors across the floor. Christine, you're up.
I'm going to kick the... Oh, he swung with his axe, so it's out of his hand. Then I'm going to put my... one of the axe blades to his throat and look at Virgie and say, what do you want?
She says, I told you to kill him. And if you want to argue about it, that's fine. But I don't think that it's going to solve anything unless he's dead. He's just going to find more rats to crawl out of the holes of the city. And they're just going to bolster his ranks back up. I say, kill him now.
Rasper looks at Bacon. And what do you say about this, old man?
Fuck you!
I bring the axe down on him. Oh, natural 1.
Oh!
Can I use an action surge to try again?
Yeah.
Great!
He moves his head out of the way.
9.
Oh, you have advantage
on
that roll. So the 9 was the second one.
Right.
So total 9. It's still going to be a miss. He is able to move his head out of the way, and you just cut a portion of his beard off.
So then, can I now use
an action? Now you may use an action surge, and you have advantage again.
20.
Yes.
Great. This time I make sure it makes contact, dealing 10 damage.
10 is enough. You cleanly cut his head off.
Great.
We've decapitated a lot of people tonight.
Today.
Today.
Virgie says, she kind of stands up, her hair is kind of fallen, and she tightens it back up, and she says, thank you. I'm sorry that I wasn't 100% honest with you, but I was afraid that you wouldn't want to help me if you knew that I was a member of the Sons of the Shipwreck. I've been trying for years. And I thank you. I will uphold my end of the agreement. I'll attach a horse to the cart, and you can be on your way. However, now, of course, that I have an idea of who you are, there might be something else you can do to really set things right.
Yeah.
I don't know if you've heard the rumors, but there's no easy way to say this. The Night Tower is haunted. The ruins of the Night Tower are haunted, and they've pretty much prevented anyone from setting back up in the city.
Okay.
If you don't mind, again, your rooms at the inn are still available, perhaps in the morning or tomorrow afternoon once
yes.
you've rested. It's not going to go anywhere. It can't slide too much further into the ocean. But if you would clear the tower as well.
Of course. I would be more than happy to.
Well, and we would be more than grateful.
My question is, though, Virgie, is we're nomadic travelers. We're not going to be in this town for long. What are you going to give us for clearing this haunted tower?
Casper says, yeah, as he's looting.
just a hand axe. You find a few bars of that metal that are on his person. She says, unfortunately, there isn't much more that this town has to give. However, I can assure you that if you do us this service, this town will always be welcome to you in your nomadic travels. I wish I had more to offer.
Would you, as I'm sure you've guessed, I am Christine de Marin.
Mm-hmm.
I whip my head to the side and go, what?
my grandfather is the one responsible for the shipwreck 15 years ago.
The axe gave it away.
Yeah, I kind of figured. The manta ray is our house sigil. We don't really parade it. As Clarion knows, there is kind of a bad reputation with my name and Damarin's folly.
Well, I don't mean to insult you, but I do have to finish the song as it goes. And the Night Tower too fell into the blue. And Lord, Surf, and Sailor all drowned. I did pick it up on my way through.
Yeah. So I guess if anyone could clear out the Night Tower, it would be me. If after all this, if you would do me the favor of helping rebuild Damarin.
Marinton? Absolutely.
Right. It's been a while. I was 5 when I left, so, and I've never come back until today. So if you would help do that for me, I would like to one day return here and claim my birthright. But I don't really have the reputation or the standing or even the funds to do so.
Well, funds I can't help with, but I can certainly help you with the people while you're delivering your cart, or while you I'm sure you're gonna have to go present yourself to Easterton,
yes.
to Lord Easter. But I can offer you my services here to help you if you'll clear the tower and. As well as, I guess, claim to any treasure that you find there, not that it's mine to offer.
Great. That'd be wonderful. Thank you so much.
Absolutely. Thank you. I'm sorry that you had to kill my dad for me. But it's not every day that heroes come through town.
Hmm.
Aww.
Very good. At this, I again bid Virgie adieu, and I exit out the door.
Great. You guys walk. I assume you're heading back to the inn to rest and to go to bed. So you do that. You head back to the Brass Lantern, and maybe you have a glass of ale, not a glass of cold ale, or
straight to bed, actually.
Yeah. Yeah.
10 glasses.
Yeah. 10 glasses of a cold glass of ale, or 10 glasses of ale, and then you drift
off to sleep. We'll call it there. Thank you all very much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. Leave us your comments. The winning comment of this was, it wasn't really the top comment, but I really liked it, was Sturgeon Clean. It didn't exactly work out because I had already named the inn. I was going to name the inn the Clean Sturgeon. But I forgot I had already named it. So please give us your comments. We'd love to hear what you think. Thanks for tuning in, and we'll catch you next time on Threshold.